Right, so they can't actually eat. They have to eat the chicken. Has to be chicken. Otherwise they won't be able to survive, which I'm a dumb fuck. I need to cryopod it before it dies. Okay. Do I even have a taste? I do have chicken. Where is that? Bring that back out. So it needs to survive for Chitrin. I can't do much about it. Need paste. One. Trying to get that vassal. Maybe that will help. Where is it? That's it. I actually know you used the battle before, so I don't really know where it is. Instructions, that's all it says. Here it is. It's in furniture. I'm in there for now. Okay. riding the Ganther saddle. I wonder if that's that weird fucking bug type thing. What? Looking for what?
Look for a reason. A time travel.
I've done it, yeah. Ooh. Scary croc. Why is there a fucking crocodilian up here? That. Oh no, that's a fucking funny dragon. From this angle, it looked like a fucking crocodile. I was like, wait a minute, why is there a crocodile this far up? Let's grab one of those. Let's grab one of those to preserve the food a little bit more. It doesn't really matter to me, considering I've got a lot of it. Okay, so, I need to capture a flyer, see if I can remember. Now it should be 10 nearby that I've set up. Now I don't know if it's up at the back of here, I'm pretty sure it is, so I'm gonna go up here, and hopefully there's a thingy up here. I have a feeling it is up here. Yeah. So I need to find an RG. Have it follow me. Okay, I'm gonna need, actually wait a minute, did I do that? Yes I did. Alright, so this guy is gonna go and hide probably about here. I need to kill all these predators nearby. Okay, this guy's gonna just chill out here. He is on, or she is passive. So let's go around and get that fucking RG to follow us. Wait, let's see it. Whether or not I'll be able to, like,
you're bleeding all over the place.
Attention. Right, there's one right there. Come on then. Follow me then. Fucking rock column. As long as I don't go near it. Sorted. Now, I just have to beat the crap out of it. Don't get yourself killed now. And that's how it's done. I do want to get Petrodon because I can bolo them. And a Petrodon will fly a bit better. Well, that's doing that. I'm going to go and bully this thing. Yeah, there's horses on here, which are good. If you have carrots, they're pretty good for that. You need carrots to tame them. So I need a torso still. Prime meat in here. Yep. It's a low level, but that's not a problem. Since it's tamed, I can put an RG set on it. Think of that, I need to actually make one. So I need to try and... good thing about the horses is that you can basically do your like narcotics on it, narcotics, cement paste, gunpowder, stuff like that. There you go. It was this way that I came down. Oh, hello. Yeah, I think it was this way, if I'm not mistaken. There'd be a dragon somewhere. I'm going inland, I'm not sure. Feels like I am. Yeah, I've just gone inland. But that's fine, I need to go inland anyway. I need to find Selenium Compulse. I know the general location. It's getting there, it's a pain. I think it's this way. I could go by RG, but can't be fucked at precise moment. Where is my RG? There it is. Alright, so there is loft on this one, alright then. What I'd do is probably tame one of them when I got the equipment. Because they're good for getting chitin. Ooh, bright eyes. Oh, that works. At the fucking wyvern nest. It is super bright, unfortunately I can't, I could just put down my gamma, but then I won't be able to see much. Give me a sec, I try it now, where is it, gamma, where are you? There it is. I put it down about there. Apply, save. It did nothing. This map is naturally just too bright. If I put down to about here, and then save it, it's a little bit better. But it means that night is going to be super dark. Give me a sec, I'm going to just change the gamma again. To put it back into the middle. Apply, save. And it will be bright, but it won't be as bright as it usually is. For instance, like that. You can barely see out there. You can still see everything else. So I need paste, electronics, metal, and polymer. Polymer I've got. I can get that from pretty much mantises and some other creatures. I can't remember what. Metal. Need electronics, which needs silicon pearls for that. And need paste. I need to increase the movement speed mainly on this one. Before I do anything, I should have parachutes. If not, I need to make some. So I need thatch. What I'm going to have to do is turn the brightness all the way up again when I go into that trench. And the reason why I say I'm going to have to do the movement speed on this mainly because is that when if I do end up using an RG for it, I need the speed. First of all, let's go and get some silicon pearls. Because I'm going to need silicon pearls to make the generator, and I need a generator if I want water turret. Because what I'll be doing is probably using the water turret as a protection against the wyvern. Didn't mean to do that. 30 seconds, that one. That's a UTU down there. Alright, you see that water, like grey kind of area, this bit here? I can find silicon pills in this because this used to be a lake. At least that's what I think. So I need to follow this till I find some silicon pills. Now, the silicon pills will not show up. I have to actually be walking around on there to see them. I just have to like do that. I'm gonna keep my ID from like following me. Oh, that's a big... Is that spiny? Is that a Molotov? That's a Molotov. As soon as I pick up the first silicon, I know there's one in that area. There's more than one in the area meant. So I've been in this area. Or it's a bit further down. Because I know, I think it's in there with green with water. I think it's somewhere around here. See, there's water over there. Oh, and I think it's somewhere in that bit down there. But it's so fucking dangerous down there. It's stupid. So I'm gonna start at the very, very end. That all the way down here. Now there is crocodiles in here, as you can see there's some right there. And there's a pollute. Yeah, I can't pronounce these fucking things. Fucking hate those things as well. Alright, you see that greyish rock? That is what I'm looking for. Oh, be careful because of the crocodiles in this area. You see this one, two of them just chilling. If I take them out, I can take them out quickly if I can. I don't like these ones specifically because they actually lunge at you like that. Just grab the other one now. After I've killed them all. I don't have to worry about them. My OG's following me anyway, so it's good. Now let's go further down and hopefully we'll find some more.
Keep up the good work. Are we gonna just leave bio waste lying around then?
There we go, some more. You don't really want to leave without at least going through the entire thing. As long as you don't bother them, they don't follow you. They don't do anything to you. And some more. Though you do have to be careful. If you around those Titanos, they do stomp heavy, so of course they're gonna damage you if they get too close. Oh crap. Yep. And I think that's some more. If you do run out of space, just get rid of something. Like that. Okay, I don't think there's any more around here. I think it's all just stone at this point. Yep, just stone. Sorry, but my game literally just crashed there, so, I wasn't that far. I just follow my character anyway. As soon as I spawn in, it will follow me back to the ground. This is why you should always have parachutes on any game, whether it's on private or public. You should always have parachutes, because if you're high up and you haven't got any like resources like tech suit, if you have a parachute you can quickly activate it and just glide on down. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Please tell me it didn't. Where's... Yeah, really? So it looks like it glitched, and I didn't even get any of that silicon pill, so I'm gonna have to go all the way back. I have to go all the way back down there and get that silicon pill. This is one other thing you should do, is that when you're in, to save it manually, you go to your inventory, and you press the button to bring up all your information like that, and it will save it. So we have to go all the way back to that ravine that I showed you, which is somewhere over these mountains. It's a little bit of a pain in the ass. I really should get some parachutes and do it that way. Yeah, I think that's a lake down there, I'm not sure. Or it could be just a load of vegetation. Well, don't you know, three water veins in one area. Right, so so I don't have to go like miles again. As soon as we get to the chasm with all the water, I'm gonna save it and then continue on. That way if it glitches again and it boots me out, I won't have to go far. Okay, there's the first lake. I think, yeah, this should be the start. Alright, let me just... that. Save it twice. Have the RG following me. I know that. So the compose already. right now, there is a crocodile right over there. I'll jump on there, and I'm gonna attack it. The raptor's over there. Should be fine if we just ignore him. Usually that's not the case. Come on, come on. There's another watering hole right there. Best take out this puna. I'm not the fucking word. So. Come on. Pelovia. There's a crocodile. Right, off I come. I'm gonna have to get some thatch as well, because I need to make some parachutes. Now, misc and make a load of them. So, that's the main one, so I'm going to go down this way, go under here, the bear, you see the movement, it's actually bear. Alright, so yeah, we go this way, we'll come back through. I think the main one is the Aroi, or could that be the main one? I'm not really too sure. I know there's one of them that's got like a massive. Alright, so. Yeah, so this is pretty much where I. It glitched me. So. Jump off. I don't want it landing because it'll probably get crushed. I'll look around. Okay, there we go, found some. There we go, see? This is why I don't like dealing with these things. But it's a good thing I got a massive health bar, otherwise I would have been dead. My RG keeps me safe anyway. Need some more. There's one there, and there's another one somewhere else. So if I just bring that one over here. My RG getting in the bloody way. Give her the berries. I don't need them. Silicon pearls will usually be around the edges of the lakes. I always like to check in them, just in case. But you never know. Yeah, there's no one. Saber tooth over there. Right. So, go saved. Really, yeah. What are you doing, you silly thing? Yeah, just go be careful not to shoot yourself. That's one of the reasons why I don't like pluvials. They're good for traps if you want to set some up. But personally, I just don't like using them. I don't like them being used on me. Any more things I can get rid of? Let's get rid of that. I do want a raptor. Keep him to ping. Okay, you've got enough health on you. Okay. You think I've got enough? I think it's fine. Alright. Now we just head back. To the red orb. Because after the red orb I could just fly over the mountains to my other base. Oh, and this chasm, crack in the ground. There is artifacts in there. There is one in one area. I can't remember exactly where. I think it's somewhere in here. Is, yeah, here it is. It's Helena. Ah. No. Okay, RGs can only go up to that point. Which is no good, considering I need a flyer in. Well, raptors can get through, but... like I said, I prefer to be able to fly. This way I can just get there and get it over done with. Also, there's a specific part that you might need a flyer for, and that's pretty much the reason. Alright, where did I go? And there it is. Okay, I am going to leave it there. I have been on for quite a bit. I've been on about 6 hours-ish. Almost 7 hours. It's got 2 minutes left, so I might just let us listen to some of the explorer notes. Number 8 on Helena.
I have to convince them to stop. There's no way the station will allow this. This place would never allow anyone to master it. If it weren't for Raya's warning, I'd be ecstatic about what they were creating. A gateway that can help us escape the station and reach reach the planet below? It's brilliant. But the obelisks will kill everyone here before we can complete it. Just like they destroyed the village Raya told me about. I'm sure of it. Bloody hell. I'm gonna look like an absolute madwoman. I've barely settled in here, and I'm already coming to them with doomsday prophecies. I'll need to convince Mei Yin and Diana first. They're my best bet. The tribe's leadership was surprisingly receptive to my ideas, but still a bit skeptical. Apparently, they've already fiddled with one of the obelisks, and even damaged this station's control center. So while they believed my account of what happened in the desert, they think the threat is already contained. Thankfully, Diana convinced them to lend me a small team to inspect the obelisk, just in case. Better than nothing, at least. However, on this station, getting to an obelisk is something of a risky proposition. To reach them, we'll need to make a trip to the surface, which even Mei Yin says is dangerous. That means before I go, I'll need to get a crash course on that armor. My time in the desert may have given me some skill with firearms and helped me get fit, despite failing to give me washboard abs, much to my chagrin. But I'm still no soldier. That was evident to anyone who saw me flailing around in the training yard these past few days. If it weren't for Mei Yin and Diana, I'd still be crashing my tech armor into rocks or tripping over myself like a drunken dodo. Plus, I always feel less silly when there's someone to laugh at my mistakes along with me. Fortunately, Mei Yin will be accompanying me to the obelisk, so this whole thing won't rest in my unsteady armored hands. Thank God. Mei Yin and I set out yesterday, alongside a bespectacled computer expert named Santiago. He'll be the one to actually examine the obelisk. He claims that he can hack into its terminal. If it's preparing to unleash a surge of power, as I suspect, then he says that he might be able to reroute it. Rockwell, for his part, is staying behind. He's been aiding the village's scientists in their studies since we arrived and has become rather engrossed. Every other sentence with him is about that bloody medal he named after himself. It's a bit troubling, but thankfully, Diana said she'd look after him. I can't spend time worrying after Rockwell now, though. The fate of that whole village might depend on this expedition. Focus up, Helena. Let's do this. The structure of this space station must be vastly different from the others to allow for these massive caverns. Is that uncommon? Or do many of the stations vary so radically from one another? I've only seen three. For all I know, they could come in all shapes and sizes. Speaking of different, Mei Yin's been fairly talkative since we left, at least for her. She'll still grow quiet sometimes, but instead of trying to burn me to death with the invisible eye lasers, she stares into the distance and idly fiddles with her necklace. I think it depicts a plane or spaceship of some kind. I wonder where she got it. They weren't exaggerating when they said the surface was dangerous. Direct exposure to sunlight during the day will quickly burn a human to a crisp, even in this fancy armor. That means we have to adjust our sleep schedules and wait just below the surface until night falls. When it does, we'll make a mad dash for the obelisk, let Santiago get in as much work as he dares, then run our asses back to safety. Struth, I thought that bloody desert was diabolical, but this tops it for sure. Why couldn't we do something simple? Like flee from a pack of ravenous allosaurs or something? This life I lead, I swear. Santiago's still going over his readings from last night, but even without them, it seems clear that the obelisk was behaving oddly. It was pulsing wildly, and the ground beneath it received regular tremors, whole station was on the verge of tearing itself apart. If this obelisk goes off, it could mean Armageddon for every living thing here. Despite this, Santiago is insisting on analyzing his readings. The scientist in me is proud of his dedication to hard evidence. But the part of me that would rather not be obliterated by a mysterious high-tech space station really wishes he would hurry the hell up.
Okay, everyone. Thanks for joining us. Next time we'll be doing number 15 when it's when I could be fired to it if I'm not like bored out of my mind. Yeah, thanks for joining everyone, and I will see you all probably next time. Oh, hang on, what day is that? It is Wednesday. I'm not too sure. It'd be either Wednesday or Friday. Wednesday, Thursday or Friday. So, no, wait, it is Wednesday. Oh, yeah, it just became Wednesday. So, probably later on today, at 5 o'clock, well, 5 p.m. Or it'd be Saturday and, or, wait a minute, fucking got my days mixed up, god damn it. It'd be either today at 5 p.m. or it'd be Thursday or Friday. Probably won't be Friday because I'll be out on Friday. Have a good night, everyone, and I'll see you next time. Wait, what? Wait, when did I... What? When did... When did, I wonder if that was when I was getting stolen. Okay. Let me just deal with the youths, let me just get rid of them. Main track. Why can I just, oh god, no. You know what? I'll deal with it next time. Good night, everyone, and have a pleasant time. Oh, whatever. I don't know. I don't know how to do it up, truth.